In this video, I am going to talk about Shannon entropy, which is often abbreviated to just entropy, and occasionally people will also call this the self-information for a random variable. And what entropy is going to give us is a way to measure how random a distribution is. Oftentimes we'll refer to entropy as a measure for how random a random variable is. Of course, a random variable has an associated distribution, and so it's actually possible to just talk about entropy just in terms of distributions. This video is going to rely heavily on a previous video I made on Shannon information content, so make sure you understand that first. For entropy, a key idea is that something that is more random is going to be less predictable and is going to be less compressible. Somehow these three things at some level are interchangeable. Okay? So more random is going to be less compressible, which means that it's going to take more bits to store it. This last part is very key, and let me give you an example of where you might have seen this idea before. So perhaps on your computer, you've had a very big file before where you want to share it with people. So what you do, since this file is too big, is you compress it. So for example, maybe you use zip compression or gzip or something else, and what you get out typically is a smaller file, which you can share and so forth. But if you ever try to compress this smaller file again, what you'll find is that you get another file that's roughly the same size, okay? So one way to think of this is that the original document had a lot of structure. There are pieces of it that could be predicted from other pieces of it. And so at some level, you can think of it as there was quite a bit of redundancy. And a compression algorithm can take advantage of that redundancy to shrink the file into something smaller. But once you have something smaller, now there's much less redundancy. And one piece in the file here is not really going to be predictable from another piece. Okay, so when you compress again, it doesn't really shrink, okay? And so you can think of it as the bits in this smaller file are starting to look really, really random. And we can't really compress something that looks like it's totally random. And so we're just going to end up with something that's about the same size. So with this high-level picture of what's going on, let's look at how many bits it takes to store a random variable. Okay, so here we have a random variable x, which has this probability table, px. So we have a fair coin toss. Heads and tails, each with probability half, and so the alphabet script x that random variable x takes on consists of two things, heads and tails. So the question we want to ask is how many bits does it take to store n independent and identically distributed samples from the distribution px? So you can think of these n IID samples as we're just flipping the coin n times, okay? And so one way to think about this is to break it up into cases, and to first start with, well, how many bits does it take to just store those samples that are heads? Okay, so, well, first off, how many times do we see heads? Well, if n is large, then we know that the number of heads we'll see is going to be approximately n times the probability of heads. Alright, so this is roughly how many heads we see, and how many bits does it take to represent each of these heads? Well, that's going to be given by the Shannon information content for seeing heads, which is going to be, so we have a multiplied by log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability that x is equal to head. Okay, so this is roughly how many bits we're going to need to store the samples that are heads. And so if we want the number of bits to store all the samples, so for both heads and tails, of course what we do is now we're going to replace the heads with little x, and then we're just going to sum over all little x within the alphabet big script x, okay? So this now is going to give us roughly how many bits it takes to store all n samples. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to factor this n out, and note that we have this term here that I'm putting in a box. So this thing is, on average, how many bits you need to store each of these samples, okay? Because I factored out the n, so this is like a multiplier. for each of the samples, it's going to take roughly this many bits. So this thing in the box is going to be defined to be the entropy, denoted by H, of random variable X. And sometimes we'll also denote as the entropy of, and then we'll write the distribution, which in this case is P of X. Let's look at a concrete example of this distribution we have up here. What is the entropy of this fair coin toss? Well, we have the probability of heads, which is half times log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability of heads, which is half, okay, plus the probability of tails, which is half times log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability of tails, which is half. So here, this thing is log base 2 of, this whole thing is 2, so log base 2 of 2 is 1, and similarly this is also going to be 1, so we're going to have half plus half, so this thing is going to be 1 bit, okay? And I'm just looking at the entropy part and not the n. So what it means is that each of the coin flips, I'm going to need 1 bit to store it. And so this is intuitive, because for a fair coin toss, where it's 50-50 chance of being heads or tails, we really have no idea whether it's going to be heads or tails. So in order for me to figure out which one it is, you're just going to have to tell me 1 bit of information. 1 bit is perfectly going to tell me whether it is heads or tails. Okay? So in contrast, if, for example, we had the probability distribution as heads, tails, probability of heads is 1 and tails is 0, okay, then what we would have is, well, the probability of heads 1 times log base 2 of 1 divided by probability of heads, which is 1, plus 0 times log base 2 of 1 divided by probability of tails, which is 0. Okay, and so you might look at this and go like, wait, this thing's going to blow up. This thing's going to go to infinity, and I have a 0 times infinity. How do I deal with that? First off, we're going to have a convention. So this thing here, by property of log, is going to be 0 log base 2 of 1 minus 0 log base 2 of 0, and we're going to have the convention that 0 log base 2, really log base anything of 0, is going to be defined as 0. Okay? And so this thing is going to be 0 log base 2 of 1, which is 0 times 0, minus 0. And so this whole thing is going to be 0. And this thing here on the left, well, log base 2 of 1 is just 0. Okay, so this whole thing is going to be 0 bits, which is not surprising because if I perfectly knew it's always going to be heads, I don't need to store anything. I know it's going to be heads. No bits required. Okay, so just as a technical remark, you might be wondering, wait, why can we just define 0 log 0 to be 0? Are we just making stuff up? And so for that, I'll just say that if you look at x times log base 2 of 1 over x, and you look at the limit as x goes to 0, so this thing, I'll leave it as an exercise for you to see if you still remember L'Hopital's rule from calculus. This thing is going to be equal to 0. Okay, so what we're writing down here isn't actually a complete disaster. This does give us the answer that we want. Okay, so just as a remark, I will say that similar to when I talked about Shannon information content, so first off, Shannon information content can be fractional. Okay, so of course, entropy itself can also be some fractional number of bits. So for example, like 0.9 bits. And what that means is that, well, if you have n IID samples, then for large n, it's possible to store it in 0.9 times n bits. Okay? And so a final thing I will say is that if you look at the formula for entropy, this here looks like an expectation. Okay, this is a weighted average, okay, of this thing right here, which is the Shannon information content of x equal to little x. And so entropy, as we see here, is actually just equal to the expectation of the Shannon information content. Log base 2 of 1 divided by px of random variable x.